Hi, and welcome to the Assembly Line Podcast. I'm Chris Torrance. So I just got a package today from Australia. Let's open it up and find out what's inside. What do we have inside here? This is the Booti from David Mutimer. And the Booti is a hard drive emulator for the Apple II. So there's two components to it. Here's the main card, and then here is the USB adapter that plugs into it. So full disclosure, I actually bought this. This is a beta version of the Booti. It's revision 1.0. And David Mutimer is selling them for $50, at least in the initial beta run. The Booti card is designed to be used in any Apple II except for the 2C. So for example, the original Apple II, a 2 Plus, 2E, or a 2GS. For the original Apple II or 2 Plus, and for an unenhanced 2E, you can use the Booti card in what's known as basic block mode. So this will open up any normal ProDOS block-oriented disk images. And these could be .DSKs, .POs, .2MGs, etc. The only caveat is that they have to be in block order. So they can't just be a DSK in track sector order. I actually found a program by Paul Hagstrom called DSK to PO that lets you convert a disk image to a ProDOS ordered image. And I was able to convert a couple of my files so I could use them within the Booti. For an enhanced 2E or a 2GS, you can actually use the Booti card in SmartPort mode, and then you can have up to 8 SmartPort drives. I've got the Booti card in slot 6 on this enhanced 2E, so when we turn it on, I don't have any disk images currently loaded up, so it just jumps into the Booti configuration utility. And this is divided up into two sections. So there's the file list on the left, this is what's on the USB, and then on the right hand side are my 8 drives. Right now I'm in block mode. I could hit the M key if I wanted to and switch to SmartPort mode. But we'll go back to block mode. So for my 8 different drives, I can load up to 8 disk images. And these can be either .POs or .2MGs. I have a .DSK file on here. I just tried it earlier, but it didn't work because this isn't in ProDOS block order. So we won't be able to use that. So to go ahead and use the configuration utility, all you do is you use the arrow keys to scroll through your disk images, and I'm gonna have to ignore the ones with the underscore because I'm on a Mac. And for example, if I just wanted to load up, say, Flapple, I just hit enter or return, and that loads it into slot number 1. And then we can also load them into different slots. So for example, I could load the game Rogue by hitting the number 2 when I'm over that one there. And you can just go through and we'll just load up a bunch of them. So in 3 here, here's my ProDOS disk. And once you're satisfied with everything, you can go ahead and exit and then reboot. Other things you can change, you can erase what's currently selected in the disk image. You can reread the USB stick, so in case you take it out and put new images on. You can turn on a write protect toggle. So if I just hit W, you can see it puts a little W over here on the right-hand side of this particular drive. And then finally, you can set the boot delay. So this is how long it waits before you actually hit the configuration key when it starts up. So now that we're happy with this list of disk images, let's just hit exit. And it should boot in 3 seconds into Flapple. All right, let's go ahead and reboot. I'll hit Control, Open Apple Reset. If I hit the B key, it will dump me into Basic. So that's kind of a nice feature. Let's boot again. If I hit the keys 1 through 8, it'll boot me into that particular disk image. So if we do that and we hit the number 2, then it should boot into my second disk image, which if you recall was the game Rogue. Let's go back and we'll hit the Config menu. So Control, Open Apple Reset. And I'll hit the C key to go into the configuration utility. And now we'll go ahead and we'll load up, say, Total Replay by just scrolling down to it and hitting return. So you can see that put it into slot number one there, and then we'll exit. And that rebooted into Total Replay. So I have 166 games, and that's because I don't actually have a joystick hook up to this. But let's make sure this works. So we'll type C for Conan and hit return. As a final test, let's go ahead and we'll load in the alpha version of Nox Archaeus. So I'll just hit the number 4 here to load that into the 4 slot. And then when I boot up, I'll just hit the number 4 to boot that. So you can see that Nox Archaeus works well, so that's great.
The Booti Card was designed by David Mutimer with firmware support by Marko Ramius. I think they've done an excellent job with the card. There were a couple minor quibbles that I had. The first card that I received had a bad EEPROM, and David had to send me another one, but luckily that worked fine. Then, second of all, it's a little unfortunate that you can't use .waz or .dsk images. I understand why they did that, because they can only support ProDOS block images, but that unfortunately makes it so it's not a complete replacement for something like the CFFA 3000. However, for my purposes, it's actually great. I was looking for something to use as a hard drive in my Apple IIe upstairs, and now I can go ahead and use this for mounting all of my disk images and then still have a disk 2 controller card in the same computer. I really like that you can have up to 8 disk images loaded at a time and then just use the number key to select which one. So overall, I'd recommend getting a Booti Card if you need a hard drive emulator for your Apple II, 2 Plus, 2E, or 2GS. If you're not already a subscriber to my YouTube channel, please hit the subscribe button. I also have a Patreon if you want to support me that way. And otherwise, thanks for watching.